So with the soil that I'm talking about, soil health, you can see and smell and you can identify soil health by looking at it. It's crumbling, looks like a chocolate cake, and water infiltrates. What's really amazing, we've been getting a lot of rain, and look how soft and fragile this soil is, and that nice earthy smell. Now, I don't see a ton of earthworms here. If I dug around, you gotta realize that earthworms are here when you feed them. What does earthworms wanna eat? A lot of residues. And so maybe the earthworm food is pretty well digested, or else they've gone deeper, but this is absolutely beautiful soil. See, here's a worm right here. I can actually, I just haven't looked hard enough. So I can actually take a look at a soil and dig in it and watch water infiltration, and I can get a pretty good idea about soil health. But soil minerals, I gotta really do a test. I gotta do some measurements and a test, and I gotta see what minerals and where the mineral levels are. And I gotta trust the science world enough to say there's all kinds of different test methods out here. You gotta get a method that you're comfortable with, and I'll talk about testing on another video session. But this is pretty easy to identify soil health, and it's not just a matter of counting worms. I always said a method of sustainability, this ought to be look like a chocolate cake, and I said 25 worms in a cubic foot and zero soil loss is a real good measure of sustainability. Well, when are you going to count those worms? They should be really in May when there's plenty of moisture and plenty of food and they're digesting residues down, and probably in September. You wouldn't want to count them in July when the food is gone. They're going to go dormant and they're going to go deep. But they're just one of the indicators, because all soils don't have earthworms in it, and yet you can have a beautiful structure. The organisms that make this soil aren't making it for us. They're making it for themselves so they can have air infiltration, because 25% of the soil ought to be air, 25% water, and the rest of it be minerals. So they got to breathe, and that's why you always fix the soil from the top down and deepening your aerobic zone by proper tillage and lots of organic matter and deep roots in there. And that's why a system of farming I've always liked is kind of strip tilling, where you're just kind of working in those little zones and getting really deep root systems into a soil and building that nice soil structure. So you can identify soil health. That's obvious.